What's good, everyone? Hello. Welcome in for another movie reaction. My name is KL, if you're new here, and I've decided to watch all of the Ghostbusters movies for the first time. Today is movie number 2, which released in 1989, and if you missed my reaction to the first Ghostbusters, definitely go watch it, clicked up here and down in the description. That movie was far funnier than I ever could have predicted. I had the best time, and I'm so excited to continue it now. I'm ready to just kick back and hopefully laugh a lot, just like the first movie. I don't know what happens in this one in terms of story, but I also weirdly don't care. I'm just ready for a comedy. So, thank you so much again for watching me watch this movie. As always, edited version does cut out a lot, so if you want to watch the whole movie with me, come on over to Patreon. You can sync up with my watch-along reaction. And with that, let's do some busting. Five years later.
It appears to be jammed.
Okay, so Sigourney is back. Yay!
When are you gonna get around to fixing the radiator in the baby's room? Though I asked you last.
What's going on?
No!
Get it! What the hell? Oh my gosh, this poor baby. I'm gonna say the carriage initially has a mind of its own. Genuinely, this is kind of scary. Not even kind of, it is scary. Maybe somehow it was the baby, though.
How many of them are there?
14. They're in here.
Oh my gosh.
Why don't we all sit down and we'll have fun?
Yeah!
Is that the same actor for Winston from the first movie? He seems different, but maybe I'm misremembering. Oh man.
There's something strange.
They don't care. No, no.
Man, face it, Ghostbusters doesn't exist. Conjured up a 100-foot marshmallow man, through the top 3 floors off an uptown high-rise, ended up getting sued by every state, county, and city agency in New York.
But what a ride.
Memories.
And did anyone else see this happen?
Well, sure, hundreds of people. I didn't imagine this.
I'm not saying you did. It's just in science we always look for the simplest explanation.
He has fabulous hair, by the way. I don't think I said that in the first movie.
Trying to determine whether human emotions actually affect the physical environment.
Okay.
Kept them waiting for 2.5 hours, and I've been gradually increasing the temperature in the room. It's up to 95 degrees at the moment.
Oh, gosh.
Well, I'd like to bring Ray in on this, if you don't mind.
Sure, whatever you think. But not Venkman. Do you ever see him?
Occasionally.
How is he these days?
What happened?
We didn't part on very good terms. Then we sort of lost track of each other after I got married.
That makes sense. So in 5 years, her and Peter dated, split. She met someone else, got married to them, and then the marriage ended.
Thanks.
Father encouraged him.
Following up with Peter.
Hi, welcome back to World of the Psychic. I'm Peter Venkman, Milton Englund. Milt, your new book is called The End of the World. Can you tell us when it's going to be, or do we have to buy the book?
Well, I predict that the world will end at the stroke of midnight.
This year?
Mm-hmm.
Cutting it a little bit close, isn't it? I mean, just from a sales point of view, I mean, your book...
I have a strong psychic belief that the world will end on New Year's Eve.
Well, for your sake, I hope you're right. Okay, but I think my other guest may disagree with you. Now, you had another date in mind.
The end of the world will be on February 14th in the year 2016.
Well, I can confirm that didn't happen.
I received this information from an alien. As I told my husband, it was in the Paramus Holiday Inn. I was having a drink at the bar. He forced me to follow him to his room, and that's where...
That look into the camera.
Next week, though. Gimme, Ira. Hairless pets. Weird.
No
respected psychic will come on the show. They think you're a fraud.
I am a fraud.
I mean, like, self-awareness, at least.
I'm Jack Hardemeyer. I'm the mayor's assistant. I know who you are, Dr. Venkman. I just don't see any ghosts anywhere. You stay away from the mayor. He's running for governor next fall.
Oh, I'm a voter. Aren't you supposed to lie to me and kiss my butt?
Yes. Now, I want you to put the Rigo in the ark. If everything you're doing is bad, I want you to know this.
Wow. Mean.
No one listens to me.
Well, not when you are just constantly insulting them. Of course they're not going to listen to you.
This mixture you gave me is working really well.
Yes, well, I make pretty good cocktails, don't I? I think it won't be long before you can assist me in the more important restoration.
Well, thank you, Dr. Poha.
Janosz.
I've enjoyed working here, but now that my baby's a little older, I'm going to try to go back to the orchestra.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. You will not be not here.
You will not be not here.
In fact, I better go.
I don't understand this. You know, every day I say, well, can you do something? You say, no, I can't do something. Do I have a bad breath or something?
Of course not.
All right.
Oh, dear.
I think that she likes me.
Mm-hmm.
No, I do. I truly do.
What is this?
We should also check Duke University mean averaging studies on controlled psychokinesis.
Uphold it.
I'm looking for a love potion aerosol that I could spray on a certain penthouse pen.
Hi, Pete. How's it going?
Hey, well, hi, Egon.
But those science chicks really dig that large cranium of yours, huh?
I think they're more interested in my epididymis.
What are you guys working on?
Well, we're just kind of checking something out for an old friend.
I can't! No!
Now?
Dana Barrett!
My Dana Barrett?
You previously had Dana Barrett.
How good to see you.
Hello, Dana.
Hi, Egon.
Nice place.
Well, I know I'm just asking for the big hurt, but I thought I'd give us one more chance.
Hello, Peter.
Hello, Dana.
So, what would you like to do first?
We'd like to examine the baby first.
Yeah, and anything associated with the baby, especially stuffed toys. Thank you.
What are you?
So, whatever happened to Mr. Wright, anyway? I heard he ditched you and ran off to Europe.
He didn't ditch me.
You never got it, Dana. I'm a man.
Oh, my gosh.
I need to feel loved. I need to be desired.
It's when you started introducing me as the old ball and chain.
Yeah. Yeah.
He seems to be fine, Dana.
Mm-hmm. He's very healthy.
When he does sleep, where do you put him?
Right around here. I'll show you.
Venkman, would you get a stool specimen, please?
Well, we don't want to play with anything. We just want to sweep for valence.
I had those same balloons on my childhood bedroom wall. Whoa.
You want to play with a big kid? You know, I should have been your father.
I understand.
Help! He's gone completely berserk! Help!
Oh, no.
Well, he's ugly. I mean, he's not Elephant Man ugly, but he's not attractive. Was his father ugly?
Don't listen.
Babies are not supposed to be attractive.
Did his father stink? Baby. Daddy was a smelly, huh? What's your name?
His name is Oscar.
Named after a hot dog. But you're excited now because Mama's here to get your stool sample, right, Mama?
I'd like to run some gynecological tests on the mother.
Who wouldn't?
It stopped right over there.
Maybe it's the carriage that's the issue. We should inspect that.
I think we hit the honeypot. There's something brewing under the street. I've got 1118 on the PKE.
Well, what does that mean?
It means we've got goop.
Hey, how you doing?
Me? Egon is prepared for everything, dude.
Let me tell you to stop cutting.
What are you guys doing here?
You tell him to stop cutting.
Yes, I tell you why we're here. We're here because some diaper bag downtown's being a jerk. I'm making this work on a Friday night. Am I right, Peter?
Yo.
Great job acting. Good on them for acting like regular construction workers. There we go. Sentence complete.
We're gonna need a deeper reading.
We're gonna need a bigger boat.
Somebody's gotta go down there.
That'll be you. Jesus Christ.
Listen to me.
command me, Lord.
I sat on a throne of blood. What was will be. Find me a child that I might live again.
Any child?
A child?
I feel like that would hurt.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
I'm sitting here being like, hopefully it's not Dana's child, but it is going to be Dana's child.
Slime! What? It's a river of slime!
I don't know why my brain defaults to goop. Slime. Yes, slime.
See if I can get a sample.
What's going on here? What's the story?
Oh, no.
I got 3,000 phones out in Greenwich Village. I got about 8 million miles of cable I gotta check.
What are you talking about, buddy? The phone lines are over there.
What did I say to you? The phone lines are over there.
Oh, no. Hey, don't do that to Egon.
You know, with Con Ed or the phone company. We checked.
I got a major gas leak here. Where do you think all this is coming from?
Just be honest and say there's a river of slime. You're about to have the proof in a second.
Pull me up now, all right? It's some kind of activity going on with this stuff.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Hey, what's going on up there? Come on! Get me out of this hole!
Oh, shit. Well. The whole city. Oh, dear.
I happen to be here, and I thought that I would stop by to see how is it with you. How's the baby?
Oh, he's okay. Yes. Woo! He's sleeping.
Oh, but I would.
Do you need anything? Do you want me to come in?
No.
Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Definitely not a fan of that guy.
Before we begin this trial, I want to make one thing very clear. Law does not recognize the existence of ghosts.
Sounds like a pretty open-minded guy, huh?
Yeah, they call him the Hammer.
What can we do? It's all in the hands of our lawyer now.
I think you got...
Hey! Yes. Yes.
See, in a couple of years, at your first parole hearing.
I feel like I'll end up disliking that guy the most, though.
I don't think it's fair to call my clients frauds. Okay, so the blackout was a big problem for everybody, okay? I was stuck in an elevator for 2 hours and I had to make the whole time. But I don't blame them. It's one time I turned into a dog and they helped.
It's true, though.
Very good, Lewis. Short but pointless.
Aww.
I've been working underground for Con Ed for 27 years. I never saw anything like this in my life. They must have poured it there.
No, he didn't.
There was no evil
intended. There was no evil intended, no malice. Because you live here, when you live in a place and you love it like you do. What?
Oh my gosh. Lewis.
Would you please tell the court why it is that you and your co-defendants took it upon yourselves to dig a very big hole?
Well, there's so many holes in First Avenue, we really didn't think anyone would notice.
Keep that up, mister. I'll find you in contempt.
There are some things in this world that go way beyond human understanding. That is where we come in. Kitten, I think what I'm saying is that sometimes shit happens, someone has to deal with it, and who are you gonna call?
She's twitching.
She is twitching.
Fake charlatans!
Your Honor?
Shut up! Fixers like you! In decent society.
Your Honor, this is important.
And I would invoke the tradition of our illustrious father.
I love all the wind. Oh. There.
Oh, God, the Scolari brothers.
The Scolari brothers? All right, do you believe him now?
Friends of yours, I tried them for murder. They gotta do something!
Why don't you just tell them you don't believe in ghosts?
Talk to my attorney.
And that's me! My guys are still under a judicial estrangement order. They could be exposing themselves.
And you don't want us exposing ourselves.
No, we don't. Oh my gosh.
I'm in the order! Case dismissed!
Hurry, we got the case!
Now do something!
I always forget how short Rick Moranis is.
No. Ray.
I love Egon's laugh.
You got him! Make it, bring it
back! Okay.
Make sure not to look in it. Sweet. You guys still got it.
Ghostbusters!
Back in business.
Ghostbusters. Yes, we're back.
I like that Winston kind of feels like the part-time Ghostbuster. Like, he's not, like, he wasn't part of that, what we just went through now, but now he's here with them. So it's like they called him up and they're like, hey, we're back, so we need you again. Please come back. Oh my gosh. It's crazy how much the effects have improved in 5 years.
Who are you going to call?
Ghostbusters!
I love that they got Lewis in for that.
Have we all gone mad?
I guess so, Pete, because that's not all.
Oh, you mean the Ghostbusters hot beverage thermal...
Should I get spoons?
Don't bother. Watch this.
You worthless piece of slime!
So you just have to insult it?
Whatever this stuff is, it responds to human emotional states. Mood slime.
Mood slime.
We've been running tests to see if we can get an equally strong positive reaction.
What kind of test?
We sing to it, and we talk to it. And...
You're not sleeping with it, are you, Ray? Oh, you. It's always the quiet ones.
You have.
How about the kinetic?
It's always the quiet ones. Great line. Oh my god, that was creepy looking. She saw it though. Trust your eyes.
You're good. Pretty eyes.
I didn't paint it. I'm just cleaning it.
Well, aren't you going to introduce me to your friend?
Sure.
This guy.
Yes, I have, of course, seen you on the television.
That was a very weird non-handshake.
Say, Johnny, you gotta go again too.
No, actually, I'm preparing this portrait for the new romantic exhibition. This is Prince Rigo.
Bit of a sissy, isn't he?
He was a very powerful magician, Dr. Rinkman.
He was also a lunatic and a genocidal madman. The feeling that that painting is watching me, even smiling at me.
Mm-hmm. Great. Ew. Looks intestinal. Yeah. Yeah. The bathtub changed shape and everything.
I didn't know where else to go. The most awful thing happened. The bathtub was trying to eat Oscar.
All right, you're all safe now, okay?
Yeah, Dana's just come over to my place. Well, actually, her tub tried to eat her.
What? Are you serious?
Her tub tried to eat her.
Remember the painting Venkman mentioned?
Uh-huh.
Ran the name Vigo the Carpathian through the occult reference net.
Ooh. Nice, ugly history. You think there's a connection between this Vigo character and the...
I'm gonna say yes.
It's the atomic weight of cobalt, 58.9.
I have been holding onto this for a long time, Oscar. I got this from a girl who got this from Joe Willie Namath, okay? So I would appreciate it if you would not hose this thing down. You know,
get out of here. Oh, look at him. Oh, he's a coconut, this guy.
Whoop. What is that?
Aw. Baby is so cute. I feel like she's kind of starting to like him again.
Hi. Come on in. This is my place.
So how are we going to handle the sleeping arrangements?
Well, what's best for me is if I lie on my side like this and you spoon up, you...
Oh, my God.
We do it the other way. I get your hair caught in my throat, and I choke in the night.
Wow.
Well, how about you on the sofa and me and the baby in the bed?
Yep, that's the ideal arrangement.
Your belly button sticks out too far, and you're a terrible burden on your poor mother.
Okay, so no reaction. Not like the slime, anyway.
You did get something on that Vigo character you mentioned.
It's poisoned, stabbed, shot, hung, stretched, disemboweled, drawn, and quartered.
Oh my gosh. Imagine doing that to a 105-year-old.
Vigo the despised and Vigo the unholy.
Oh, okay. Well, deserved then.
Suck in the guts, guys. We're the Ghostbusters.
Oh, please go, you.
Who's this wiggler?
He's yours, Ray. Sicken.
Can I tell you what I told your friend?
We're just doing a routine spook check.
If Dr. Reitman then is not here.
We got a report there was a major creep in the area. We checked our list and you were right on the top.
Well.
Please. Would you look this way, please?
No, don't. No.
Come on, show me something.
No, slides are available in the gift shop.
Good, good. Ooh, angrier. Ooh, I'm scared. You're scaring me. Stop it. Yeah. Gimme hot and sexy. Can you do it? Ooh, you can. All right, just drive me now. Yeah.
Bangman, maybe stop.
I've worked with better, but not many.
Hey. Huh? Hey, you finished?
Oh, that was strange.
Dana, your prince. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. She cleaned.
I was fully expecting him to say she left.
They tried on some of your clothes, made some long-distance phone calls, cleaned out the fridge.
Did they find anything?
They found a little bit of that pink slime.
Well, what am I supposed to do now?
You are supposed to get dressed and get crazy with me on the streets of Manhattan tonight. I have got you a babysitter, Janine Melnitz, from my staff.
Janine has experience babysitting.
I'm going to say no, but maybe she does. Who knows?
Don't put any of those old cheap moves on me.
No, 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 no.
It's different.
I have all new cheap moves. I have more than two grades of laundry, okay? There's not just clean and dirty. There are many subtle levels, okay?
We all have that, don't we?
Do you maybe want to... Oh, no, no. Do you want to have something to eat with me?
Aww.
Yeah, I'd love that, but I told Dr. Vinkman I'd babysit for him. Do you want to babysit with me?
Okay, I would.
Bye.
His place at 8. All right, well, I can get his address from the dog, too.
Now, there's definitely a living presence there.
We should get a deeper look.
I know what it is. I've seen it before. When you guys had me dangling like a worm on a hook 100 feet below First Avenue, that's the river of slime.
Oh?
You need a blanket or a hose or something, you know?
Oh my gosh, what? You have a window? Although, you're probably far too high to go out of it. Hey, Winston, thank you. Good friend.
Pete, it's great that you're here. We've got incredible news.
The spectrogram shows a river of slime flowing behind him.
Now we're going into the subway and sewer system to see if we can trace the source of the flow.
Dana, the guys are going down into the sewer to check for slime stuff. And Egon thinks there may even be a huge... You want to blow off this dinner thing and go with them?
Taxi!
Whoa! Will you watch your step?
According to this old transit map, there should be an entrance anywhere along here somewhere.
This is too dark to see the cockroaches.
It's the subway rats you got to worry about. Big as beavers.
Yeah, some of them go 4 or 5 kilos.
Hey, enough, all right?
Hello?
Okay, I'm out of here.
Oh. Gosh, okay. What the is right?
Sounds like a train.
These lines have been abandoned for 50 years.
Probably in one of the tunnels above us.
Sounds awfully close to me.
Ghost train? Ghost train. No.
I think that was the old New York Central, City of Albany. Derailed in 1920, killed hundreds of people. Did you catch the number on the locomotive?
Sorry.
Yeah. I also missed it.
Ray?
Ray!
Oh no, Ray.
Go! Oh, sorry. I found it!
There we go! The River of Slime.
Alright.
6 feet.
Well,
give me something pulling.
Hold on.
I'm trying to pull. Give me a hand. Give me a hand.
He better not end up. No. No. Oh, okay. Okay. I just made the assumption that, like, nobody could go in the slime. They both look very nice, though.
Speaking of breaking up with neat guys, why did you dump me?
I didn't dump you. I was protecting myself. I mean, you weren't very good for me, you know.
Well, heck, I'm not even good for me.
You're much better than you realize.
I mean, if I had this kind of support on a 24-hour-a-day basis, I could have myself whipped into shape by the end of this century.
So the seven little dwarfs had a limited partnership in a small mining operation.
Aww. I knew that Lewis would be good with the baby.
Because they didn't have to withhold Social Security or income tax or nothing, which you're really not supposed to do, you see. But...
And honestly, the way he's speaking, that's the best way to talk to a baby.
You're very good with children.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, I practiced on my hamster.
So you live alone?
Oh.
Why don't you come over here and sit with me? I think motherhood's a very natural instinct. I like a child myself.
Oh.
Tonight?
Fun. I'm rooting for them. I do think Lewis is going to be very oblivious, though. It's crazy that the slime now looks purple. Red and purple are close enough. Pink, whatever.
Come on, it's go time, man.
I'm so curious what it actually is on them. You can fun fact me in the comments below.
Oh, dear Ray, what are we doing? I was ready to kill you.
It's the stuff. It's like pure concentrated evil.
It's all flowing right to this spot.
Oh, did you show the stick?
No, no.
It's all flowing right to the museum.
Yeah, the museum.
Right. Oh gosh, careful.
You can never go back there again. You're gonna have to find a new job.
I told Magnus you're a class. We got there here. We gotta see the mayor. Well, Dana, we were just babysitting, honest, and we watched some TV, and we had something to eat, and then one thing led to another.
How was your date?
Well, it wasn't a date. It was just dinner.
Well, where's Peter?
Well, he was arrested.
Typical. He was a little fussy at first, and we just gave him some French bed pizza. Passed right out.
Good. Well, I'll just give him a look.
I'm worried. Okay, so far so good.
So you think we should go?
Gee, I don't know. I don't think we should leave her alone.
You're right. Let's stay.
We're here tonight because a psychomagnetheric slime flow of immense proportions is building up beneath the city.
Negative human emotions are materializing in the form of a viscous psychoreactive plasm with explosive supernormal potential.
Does anybody speak English?
I mean, do we really have to listen to this?
Can't you stop your lips from flapping? What am I supposed to do? Go on television and tell 10 million people they have to be nice to each other?
Yeah.
Being miserable and treating other people like dirt is every New Yorker's God-given right. Your 2 minutes are up. Good night, gentlemen.
You're making a big mistake.
I'm enjoying the story of this one way more than the first movie. Oh, no.
The mayor wants them kept under strict observation for the next few days. We think they're seriously disturbed and potentially dangerous.
Hi, Vigo, the scourge of Carpathia.
Oh, you've told me this, the scourge. Sorrows, I've heard all of this.
Oh, man.
He needs to repeat it every time.
Bring me the child that I might live again.
This woman, Dane, is fine and strong. If I... was to bring the baby. Could I have that woman?
So be it, wife to you and mother to me.
Hmm. Okay. No. Go check on Oscar now.
Oscar?
Ah, Oh my gosh. Oh.
It was a ghost!
No, no, that was Janosch.
What?
Where's the baby?
The museum!
Love it. She knows immediately what to do.
We gotta find the guys.
As I explained before.
Don't look at me. I think these people are completely nuts.
Oh my gosh, Venkman. Oh. Okay. Just gonna cover the entire building. God, this is so creepy looking.
Thought I'd lost you. I'd never see you again.
I thought that you might come.
You stay away from us, Janosch.
He has been chosen to be the vessel of the spirit of Vigo.
No, thank you.
You? Doesn't that sound nice?
No.
You're not gonna take my baby.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
You bastard!
I won't lie, the baby actually, like now that I'm seeing them in the same room, they actually kind of have similar faces. Like, they do look like baby and old man of the same person. What on what? That was so that was so random.
Oh, just the skeleton, huh? Well, which way was it heading?
Wait a sec. What was chasing you in the park?
The Ghostbusters are going to get out of their little room that they're currently in.
What's the problem?
He says the Titanic just arrived.
Oh my gosh.
All right, we've got no choice. Call the Ghostbusters.
Wait.
Call him.
I spent an hour last night in my bedroom talking to Fiorello LaGuardia, and he's been dead for 40 years.
Call him!
Well, I had them committed to the psychiatric ward at Parkview Hospital. They were threatening to go to the press. I was protecting your interests.
Well, you can stop protecting my interests. You have exactly 3 minutes to clear out. You're fired!
But...
Leave. Leave.
Somebody get me the Ghostbusters.
Vigo wants it on the 21st century. He needs a human body to inhabit. Little Oscar must be it.
And I bet we're the only ones who can do anything about it.
Yep, yep, you are. Mm-hmm.
It looks like a giant jello mold.
I hate jello.
I don't hate jello, but I'm not a fan. It's never been a go-to anything for me.
Marry me, baby.
No.
Together we will raise Vigo as our son. I'm sure we could get a magnificent apartment, car, free parking.
If I was the leader of the world, I would want way more than that.
Perhaps you and I could learn to...
No.
Love each other?
Yes.
Yes, pretend. Pretend so you can get your kid.
Let's cook! Save him!
That did not do much at all.
It would take a tremendous amount of positive energy to crack that shell, and I seriously doubt that there's enough goodwill left in this town.
There gotta be a few sparks of sweet humanity left in this burned-out burg.
We need something that everyone in this town can get behind. We need a symbol.
Something that appeals to the best in each and every one of us.
Something pure.
Kind of makes you wonder, doesn't it? Whether she's naked under that toga.
Oh my gosh.
She's French. 1, 2, testing. Hey, how many of you people here tonight are a national monument? Would you...
Almost looks like silly string. Like thicker silly string.
Pilot controls are ready.
All right, it's getting late.
I love that the humor doesn't even have to be anything with the dialogue. That was awesome. Wow. I was wondering how this would look. I'm
Man, I can't wait to see people's faces when we come on shore.
Same. Same expressions they had the last time we saw those two. Oh shoot, here we go.
I was born to wear this stuff.
cute. Very cute. Oh my gosh. I love that he gets his moment, though.
Minutes to go, and then party time.
Oh my goodness.
It's really pretty.
There we go.
Run here! You don't know who that is?
Happy New Year!
You are like the buzzing of flies to him!
Hose him.
Boy, am I glad to see you.
Oh, Oscar.
Love the music. Oh, no.
All right, now listen. You gotta stay right here. Don't move.
We're really leaving Oscar by himself.
You want a baby? Go ahead and knock up some willing hellhound. One!
Ooh, nope, not quite. Try again.
Oscar, please do something.
And anybody tell you the big shoulder look is out? Only a Carpathian would come back to life now and choose New York.
Oh dear. Where did,
people outside, huh?
Oh, okay.
I'm here with you guys.
Aww. Great catch.
Get back in the painting!
Viggy, 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 you have been a bad monkey.
Ray, we'd like to shoot the monster. Could you move, please?
Ray!
No!
No! Okay. Okay. Oh, gosh. Okay, think that worked. I love that for Lewis. Let's not tell him otherwise. Oh. Especially look with all these witnesses. Love it.
Spread out, Charlie.
Cute, 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 cute.
I love you guys.
We love you too, Ray.
You had a violent, prolonged, transformative psychic episode. Huh?
Sorry we had to hose you there, but you were kind of out of control. Let me tell you something. I love you.
Well, I love you too.
You want to take a look at this?
What are we about to see?
Early Renaissance, I think. Raphael or Piero della Francesca?
No, I believe it's one of the fettuccinis.
Who are you gonna call? Wow, that movie flew, dude. That went by so fast! Twins. Y'all did great. And Slimer. All right, Ghostbusters 2. That was my reaction to it. And if you enjoyed it, click that like button down below to let me know. Thank you so much for watching. Let's talk about it. This movie was so much fun. Once again, I just had like the best time. Laughed so much, my cheeks hurt from smiling. And you know what? I actually could get behind this story in this one just a little bit more than the first Ghostbusters. That said, the bad guys, and I'm going to say guys plural because we had Viggo, and then I expected that man that put them in the psychiatric ward of the hospital, like I anticipated that he would kind of be like our EPA guy from the first movie, but he didn't really turn out to be that. That's okay, because here's the thing. I didn't really care about the story in the first Ghostbusters, so why should I suddenly care and critique the story in this one? I don't. Like, for me, these movies have been so much fun because of the characters, how they're written, how they act, the chemistry they have with one another, their relationships to each other, the humor that they throw out, and then just like the shenanigans that they get up to. Like, that is what I love about these movies. And I'm so glad that not only do we have our four guys back, but we also had Dana back and Lewis back and Janine back, and even the mayor was the same guy. Like, so here for it. I loved it. And speaking of all of that, Let's talk about Dana first. Dana having a child, surprised. Definitely thought it was going to be Peter's at first. Good to get a little catch up on what happened the last 5 years. But I did not expect her baby to be such an important character in this movie. So that was a lot of fun. And yeah, Dana and Peter's relationship, let's talk about that real quick. Much better in this movie compared to the first one. But you know what? Also semi-realistic, because sometimes in life, you know, you meet someone and you date and it doesn't work out. And then you kind of go apart for a few years and then kind of make your way back together. And suddenly it's a lot different and it's better. And maybe now it'll work. And that's what I see in Peter and Dana. So was totally here for that. And I also appreciate that the sexual humor from Peter especially was a little bit toned down in this movie compared to the first one, just showing a little bit of maturity, I guess. And actually the sexual humor in general was way less in this movie compared to the first one. Maybe a conscious choice on the filmmakers, because at least just comparing the two movies, like perhaps parents saw the first Ghostbusters and went, little too much for kids, so they didn't show their kids it. And then Ghostbusters 2, they're like, oh, this one's fine. Maybe, I don't know. But I did notice a little bit of the humor change. That said, there were still many moments that made me laugh out loud, and I was totally here for it. Lewis getting to wear the Ghostbusters outfit, getting to actually use the device, and having not only himself, but everyone behind him think that he alone was responsible for getting the slime off the museum. That is everything. Lewis, once again, top character for me. Loved him. And also, him and Janine, loved that. Very unexpected, but I was here for it. Totally see them together. And yeah, Rick Moranis, once again, just very good. As for our four main men, I have a bit of an opinion change. After the first Ghostbusters movie, I was a Venkman girly. I thought Peter was my favorite. This movie, I have a different favorite, and that is Egon Spengler. I really like him. He was my favorite in this movie, and I feel like if I rewatch Ghostbusters, the first one, I feel like Egon, I just think he's my favorite out of everybody. But that said, just because he's my favorite doesn't mean I don't like the others. This is just such a fun group. I feel like the actors have so much fun playing these characters, and if I remember correctly, I think that the actors for Rey and Egon are the ones that actually like write these movies. So yeah, it was good. What's interesting about this movie is I don't know that I have like a clear favorite scene or moment in this one, or even like a clear favorite line that was said or anything like that. It was fun. The whole thing was fun. I had a great time, and I am glad that you watched with me. With that, I'm gonna go to Letterboxd now. Let's see what some other people have to say about Ghostbusters 2. This question didn't even cross my mind. 3.5 stars. How did they put the Statue of Liberty back? That's a great question. 3.5 stars. A little detail I never noticed before. When Venkman delivers his classic line, "Suck in the guts, guys, we're the Ghostbusters," Winston doesn't suck in his gut like Egon, Rey, and Peter, because Ernie Hudson did not need to suck anything in. Unlike his ghostbusting colleagues, he was in peak physical condition. Kudos to him. I love that movie fact. 3.5 stars. The soundtrack goes so insanely hard in this one. I didn't talk about the music, but yeah, the soundtrack in this, I think I actually prefer to the first movie, believe it or not. And now it's that time of the video where I turn it to you and I ask you to leave your comments about Ghostbusters 2 down below. I feel like there will be a lot of you that do prefer the first one over this one, but I'd still love to know your thoughts. Favorite moments, favorite lines, let me know down below. Also, is Lewis your favorite Ghostbuster now? Because I think he's mine, even though I just said out of the four men, the originals, Egon's my fave. But if we're gonna count Lewis in as a Ghostbuster, yep, he'll be my favorite. Thank you so much for watching this with me. I really appreciate it. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, click here. I am watching the other three Ghostbusters. They'll be coming in the following weeks. And click here if you wanna watch more of my stuff. Until then, have a great rest of your day and take care, everybody.